Hi, welcome to type 2 diabetes number 8. Today we're going to look at foods that raise your blood sugar like a boss. Now, I made a video last week on sugar, and a lot of you were like, yeah, we get it, but then what about carbs? And can you give us some examples of things that we should avoid? So today I'll tell you how we classify food according to their impact on your blood sugar, and tell you which ones to avoid if you're trying to lose weight or have type 2 diabetes. Now, there are two measurements that we use. One is glycemic index, and the other one is glycemic load. Now, a lot of people confuse them, but I'll make it easy for you today. Glycemic index is a measurement of how fast what you eat changes to blood sugar, changes to glucose. But how do we know that? We compare it to glucose that has a value of 100 because it's, well, glucose. Anything that you eat that changes to blood sugar has a number. If that number is 70 or more, it raises your blood sugar pretty fast, almost like glucose. Now, anything from 56 to 69, we call it moderate. And 55 or less has a very low impact on your blood sugar after eating. Now, let's look at some examples. If we look at fruits, for example, we see that apples and oranges are much safer than, let's say, watermelon and bananas when it comes to raising your blood sugar. And I think that's why they say one apple a day keeps the doctor away, right? Doesn't say one banana or... Now, if we look at vegetables, you'll see that all the green ones that your mother was trying to make you eat when you were young are good. So call her and say thank you. And now, pause the video and let's have a minute of silence for all the potato lovers that do not know they have been drinking glucose every single day. I am very sorry for their pancreas. I think we should call it some kind of organ abuse, pancreas abuse. Now, if we look at all the grains and bread, they're almost as bad as potatoes and very close to glucose. Most beans and nuts are safe. You know, some dairy products are okay, most of them. Pasta is looking good here, but, you know, we'll talk about it later. And as expected, most of the sugary stuff raise your blood sugar pretty quickly. Now, if you consider glycemic index and use it when you're choosing the food that you eat, you're doing great. It's better than nothing, right? But we need to take it to the next level. So we will look at glycemic load. This one tells you how fast, but this one will tell you how fast and how much. So we have how fast, which is glycemic index, and how many grams of carbs are in the food. Now, of course, we need to divide it by 100 just to make it more professional, but it doesn't change anything. Doctor stuff. Anything that is 20 or more is high, 11 to 19 is moderate, and then 10 or less is low. Now, for you to understand why this one is better than glycemic index, we'll go back to watermelon. Watermelon has a GI of more than 70, so that means it is fast, changes to sugar quickly. Now, the problem is that when it starts fast, but it doesn't have a lot of carbs to change to sugar. Most of the watermelon is water. So, for the glycemic load, it's not red, it is green. Because even though it starts fast, it doesn't have a lot of carbs to change to glucose. So, it's still green. But when we look at pasta, we see that it has a glycemic index of 40-something or 50-something, right? Starts with green, but because it has too many grams of carbs, it will keep going. So at the end of the day, if you eat pasta, you will have a higher blood sugar than watermelon if you eat the same amount. Now, there's one more thing to consider. We went from how fast to how fast times how many grams in that food. We should add one more thing, how much you eat. Because if you look at bread, right, on that table, it looks like the glycemic load of bread is pretty low. But look at the grams. They're talking about 30 grams of bread. Now, who eats 30 grams of bread? A lot of people eat like 200-300 grams of bread. So it is 7 times 10. Now that you understand this, I'll put a link to this table here if you want to take more time with it. We didn't talk about meat and fats and, you know, stuff like that because they don't have carbs. They normally don't raise your blood sugar. But if they're healthy or not, that's another subject, right? For me personally, when I told you that I keep half of my plate filled with vegetables, it's not because I like vegetables more than rice, but it's because I know that they're better. Thanks for watching the video, and give it a thumbs up if you liked it so that more people can see it, and subscribe here and allow this notification bell. Have a blessed week. Bye.